Hey guys, so today we're going to be reacting to Beasties GTA 5 series episode 15. So let's get started.
Yo, what's happening guys? Welcome back to another episode of Grand Theft Auto 5. I don't even want to know what was happening just then, but I'm sure whatever it was, it involved violating this man's personal space and emotionally scarring him for life. Do you force him to wear his girlfriend's pajamas? Just wondering, because he seems to be kind of bad off. Oh boy, this doofus wants to say something.
No, it's all just a dream. It's all just a bad dream.
Yes, it's all a very, very bad dream, but one you're never going to wake up from. Trevor's like a typhoon. He just destroys everything and everyone, and you can't stop him. Boss, I know we ain't cooking, but since I helped with the Aztecas, since I helped with the Aztecas attack the lab, I thought you might think of me if you need extra gun on a job or something, chef. I can't read, can I? No, I can't. And then we have Molly. I don't know who the hell Molly is. Confirming your appointment with Devin Weston at his new development on Power Street. Yeah, please be prompt. Okay. Devin, who the hell is Devin?
Make him go!
Listen to me, boy! You shut your damn mouth! Otherwise, I know of a very, very... Is there an axe embedded in the door? Why? Why is there an axe in the goddamn door? Oh, Trevor. You took a beautiful condo and ruined it with blood on the floor. What I was gonna say is if this guy doesn't shut his mouth, I know of a very sizable... dildo that would probably hurt going up. Also, there's shit, puke, vomit, something on the bed. Okay, it is time to get the hell out of here. I feel like I've done way too many intros inside of this apartment with Trevor. Maybe next time we'll play as Franklin, but we have an appointment with Devin. Who the hell is Devin? Also, last time I was mad confused. The job the heist we were doing for Dick Face Steve, I thought it was a job to split the money, sort of like the jewelry store heist with Michael, but in fact, it was us doing a job for Steve completely free of charge. We weren't going to take anything because when we robbed the armored truck, it was government bonds or something to do with the government that the corrupt FIB agents wanted. And can you stop snorting and spitting and what was he about to do? Oh, you were going to blow your nose on the ground. Well, I guess it's better than doing it inside. I'm starting to think Trevor's the type of guy that would just pop a squat and shit on the floor. Even though the bathroom is 2 feet that way. Okay, so with that being said, let's go down here to, or rather up here, to this Devin person and see what's up. And yeah, we're not getting paid for the job we did last time. It's starting to be a theme, I've noticed. Doing work for absolutely nothing. I feel bad for Franklin. He got roped into all this and he did the jewelry store heist, got paid some decent money, and yes, I'm stealing a car, even though mine's parked over there. Life of a criminal. But now it's like we're doing jobs and getting nothing for it. So Franklin is really sticking his neck out and possibly getting into trouble for nothing. I feel bad for him. Then again, we were doing jobs with Lamar and basically killing, I don't know, 5 or 10 people per job and walking away with nothing. So Franklin's better off with us than he would be, I don't know, working for Lamar. Speaking of Lamar, at some point we gotta drop in on my homie and see what's up. If he's still alive somehow, I will be very impressed. But enough rambling. Let's go to Devin and see what's up. Okay. Mr. Devin, what's up, my man? What are we doing today, eh? Wait a minute. I was driving an SUV. Now I'm in a truck. How did that happen? I don't know. Sup, Devin? Oh, Franklin's here.
We hear you're a competent repo guy, yes?
This is kind of like a little hobby of mine, requisitioning the underappreciated... possessions of my contemporaries for some wealthy communists in China who value them much. Well, rather my so-called friends, like, why? Why? Because they have things nobody else has, because they can afford it, because frankly, I'm rich enough to do whatever the fuck I want, and you're poor enough not to ask me any goddamn stupid questions. Now, I mean that as a friend. Namaste.
That's a nice fucking speech about the value of friendship.
Oh, of course, you must be the creepy one.
Not coming from you, please. What's going on?
You're gonna dress up as traffic cops, and you're gonna rob two trust fund kids that I know and dislike intensely.
Why?
We can get a good price for the vehicles in Asia. Look, complete the work. work, you'll all be well paid.
You're late, sugar tits.
Yep. So what's going on?
You finally get to realize your childhood dream and dress up as a cop.
Mr. Weston's research team suggests the two boys like to ride on the Sonora Freeway.
Sounds manageable. Hey, you two get going.
What the hell are you doing with your legs?
He's obviously been with Fabian, the yoga instructor.
My life's already way the fuck out of control.
All right, look. I'm a Darwinist brother, all right? Some prosper and some struggle. Now, are you out of your goddamn mind? This is your lucky break. Choose. Now, are you going to do this, or have you simply found your level in life?
I guess we'll find out.
Yeah, I guess we will, homie.
Oh, I don't like your attitude at all. How would you like a fist up your ass, huh?
Piece of shit.
Oh, I mean, he said I'm poor. Technically, I suppose in Los Santos I might be poor because I have a measly $237,000. But I could move somewhere else in America and be well off, let me tell you. It's not like Los Santos has everything you could ever offer. All the drugs, all the strippers, all the thugs. It's a good life here, right? For a criminal. Okay, so let's go to the gas station. We're back to repoing cars, baby! Except this time I'm actually going to be paid. At least that's what they've told me. Oh, wait, I'm not... I just realized I'm Franklin now. I started off as Trevor, now I'm Franklin. Got it! Oh, we haven't actually done a job with my boy Franklin in a few minutes. Can you get out of the way? And it might be nice to catch up. Oh, wait, that's right. Someone told me to call Lamar when I have a chance because there's something funny I can hear from him. I think. Lamar. I guess we'll find out. If he answers. He might not answer because I'm on a job.
What up, this LD? If you're a dude, hang up my line right now. If you're a bitch, leave a message.
Lamar's a funny guy. I don't know if that was the message or not, but we'll call him again after this job. Okay, I'm gonna drive to the objective and not talk forever, so I'll be right back. Oh, okay, we're calling Michael for whatever reason.
Hey, Frank. Hey, I'm nearly with these dudes, man. You guys comfortable on your end?
Yeah, I guess. We look pretty ridiculous.
All right, man. Look, I'll see you soon.
Yeah. We'll pick you up coming through Grape Seed. Get the drivers there and get them going at speed.
Oh, so that's what we're doing. Okay. I was wondering how this mission was going to go down. So basically, I'm driving what I'm guessing to be a Jag in GTA. And I'm going to challenge these two guys to a race because they have very nice cars. And then Trevor and Michael are dressed up as police officers and they're going to pull them over and basically, I don't know, confiscate their vehicle or impound their vehicle. But here's the thing. I love your plan. It's just there's one small hitch in everything, and that is nobody. And I mean nobody is ever going to believe that Trevor Phillips is a legitimate police officer. Michael, sure, but Trevor? They're especially going to know when we're in a hot pursuit. And instead of the police officer saying, "Please pull over in the name of the law," he says, "Pull over or I'll break my foot off in your ass and fuck your mother." That's gonna give it away pretty quickly, but still, I'm ready. Vroom vroom, bitches, you wanna race?
I'm telling you, 2.7 millimeters.
They got nice cars,
too. Hey, how about we see if one of you two is for real? So get in your cars and let's see if they move as fast as your mind.
We were just getting out of here anyway.
You want to race, bitches, in your multi-million-dollar cars that are super fast? And I am totally getting smoked. I'm driving a Jag. It's got, what, a V6 in it, a V8? They're driving exotic supercars. Like, what is that? I'm pretty sure that's a Koenigsegg and a Pagani. I am getting smoked. They've got, like, what, V12s in there? I am so dead. But I guess the goal isn't really to beat them in a race, it's to get them racing, so the very legitimate, not meth head Trevor Phillips can pull them over, right? But I do have an ace up my sleeve. I have my ability, which I never use for whatever reason, hyperfocus. So, oh yes, this is beautiful. Although I don't think that is going to help me catch them. They've got really fast engines. Of course, I know nothing about cars at all, but still.
Yeah, it will help.
Yeah, that's right, boys. Yeah, smoke me. Go ahead.
If you use
There's
that.
Totally not police officers waiting up there to pull you over, and these officers aren't exactly conventional. They're not going to pull you over and then cuff you and take you to prison. They're probably going to shoot you in the back of the head, yeah, and then sell your car to Chinese people for some reason. gotta love your friends. This guy is apparently friends with these two, and he's having us steal their cars because they don't appreciate them. Well, that's a great thing to do for your friends, right? Oh, you don't appreciate your wife? Well, I'm just gonna take her. Those are not the type of friends I need. And I also can't crash this car, I'm pretty sure, otherwise the mission might be scrapped. It's Devin's beloved car. Oh, you guys are real fast. I'm driving a $200,000 car, and you're driving multi-million dollar supercars. And you're not even faster than me. You're just barely ahead of me. You should be embarrassed. You have no driving skills. And what you do have is a lot of daddy's money. Pathetic. Put a thug behind a wheel, and I will probably be doing drive-by shootings at 200 miles an hour. Oh, that got him to slow down. What's your matter, buddy boy? Scared? I'm pretty sure that's a Bugatti. Probably saying the name wrong, but still. Ooh, that is a nice car. You guys scared? You scratch your car in the race, and it might be like $3,000, right? I mean, if you want to include a manual in some of these cars as an option, it's a couple thousand dollars. Whoa! Okay, hey, that's playing dirty. That's real dirty. You know what? I'm gonna get around this guy and smoke him. Oh, never mind. I'm calling Michael now. Fantastic.
Hey, we're coming up now, man. Be there in a few seconds.
Got it.
Well, here they come.
Hey, you guys look real pretty, and they even have the donuts. Oh, Trev, you look different. You're not yourself. You're not wearing a shirt covered in blood, semen, or shit. Oh, is that how that works? I have never been in a high-speed pursuit before. If I can handle it. Oh, listen, don't worry. I'm an expert driver. As I spam the keys, hoping to have that focus vision thing that Michael or Franklin has, but I don't. See, I'd prefer to drive as Trev right now because he has that meth vision. Oh, wait, actually, no. Meth vision only works when you're using guns, right? I don't think it slows time down.
Stop.
You know, I can think of a thousand ways we could have done this besides chasing them down on police bikes wearing stolen police uniforms. Damn, there's a lot of rolling meth labs out here. Jesus Christ. We could have, like, I don't know.
Our patience will be rewarded. Stay with them.
Snuck up in the middle of the night and just taken their car straight from their, you know, garage. I mean, this is so much more work. More rolling meth labs. You know those are meth labs. I mean, come on.
Stay on them, T. They'll stop eventually.
That is a lot of RVs. Holy shit.
Coming up on Toledo Bay. Good, gain some ground on them.
Is that a fact?
Blue one eye, catch these assholes.
Oh, there's his inner police officer coming out. What are you going to do?
I can swear we've circled half the state. Bikes at the back. I think they wanted to stop when they were poking.
How you doing, T? We gotta hang in there.
He's insulting bikers over his loudspeaker. Oh, legitimate police officer for sure. You guys can tell he's a real police officer, right? That's unfair. I want a loudspeaker.
It's about time.
Oh, that's because we're in the corners now. Oh. Yeah, you guys have nice cars, but you don't know how to use them. What's the point in having an expensive fast car if you can't handle it? Go ahead, hotshot. Try and corner at 200 miles an hour. See what happens. I mean, at this point, you guys are gonna pull over? I would have kept going. You're already basically gonna get a ton of, I don't know what they call them. Penalties?
Whoa, hey. Stay in
Fling
the car
the police?
There, homeboy. I'll deal with you later.
Fuck you, too.
You know how fast you're going?
Gee, I don't know, officer. I try to keep it under the limit.
Well,
really?
You boys looked like you were drag racing from where we are sitting there, so why don't you get yourself out of the car? Come on.
Officer.
Yes, it is. Get out. Come on. Hands on the car. Let's go. Come on.
Get out of the fucking car!
Damn, Michael's more aggressive than Trevor.
All right, we gotta make sure.
Get out of the fucking car, you fight
damn!
Tank, prick.
Well, this is a reversal of the roles? Jesus! Oh! Oh, this is a new law. Police officers can now take your vehicle and use it for their own. Goodbye!
Man, I'm sick of driving so slow staying with these fools. Can we have a real race?
Well, you talk a good game. Okay, just don't scratch the car.
Oh, so now we're gonna race? Aw, shit, let's go, boys! Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the Koenigsegg. Damn, this thing looks nice.
Speak.
Ah, the lady from before. Devin's assistant. Good to be working with you.
It's Molly Schultz, Senior Vice President and General Counsel to Mr. Weston's holding company.
Well,
and if
damn.
You think it's good to be working with common thieves, well, you're very mistaken. Have you got the cars?
Wow, the whole resume. Yeah, we got the cars.
Bring them to Hayes Auto on Little Bighorn in South Los Santos. Mr. Weston and I will meet you there.
Well, okay, miss, I have a stick up my ass.
It's Evans, man, woman, lawyer person. I'll be waiting at Hayes Auto in South L.S. for you idiots to show up.
Yeah, right.
I am so sorry. Speaking of a very expensive job, probably scratching this car would come out to $1,000. Just a small scratch.
Well, looks like you guys are fighting it out for second and third.
Okay, I cannot afford to make a single mistake.
Hey, Frank.
Yeah?
What'd I tell you, bro? These cars. This is an opportunity.
Yeah, if you say so. You know what, right before I met you, I was boosting rides and racing. It feels like it come full circle to me.
Come on.
No, I'm serious. If you hadn't got me fired from my repo job, that's exactly the kind of shit I'd be doing. So thanks, dog. After all the crap we've been through, man, you got me right back where I'd be at anyway.
Ha ha!
But at least we're getting paid for repoing cars this time. With Simeon, I don't even think he was getting paid. Or at least not very well. He's still living with his aunt. See, this is how you have to do crime.
Devin Weston, he ain't like anyone you worked for before.
Man, he runs his mouth, wants me to boost cars, and most likely gonna be paying me a fraction of what they worth. It don't sound that different, to be honest.
You must know who this guy is. Look him up. He's the real deal. I've seen his house. He can make things happen.
So, he like, to you, what you were to me. I see your house, I think this dude can take me places.
Yeah, maybe. Something like that.
But like I was saying, this is how you have to do crime. If you're gonna commit any type of crime, you had better not crash a very expensive car into the back of a pile of shit. I'm gonna sue you for being poor! Oh shit, oh they're beating me, oh no. I am the world's worst driver.
What do you mean? Like, how am I gonna beat your ass in this race? Don't worry, I'm taking care of that.
I mean, is it just the smell of green? Or is there some other thing with this guy and you? You know, feels funky.
Hey, I'm just trying to do what's best for Frank. You know.
Hello?
Hello.
What's your dad?
He's out walking the dog.
Down this heat.
Making a video.
Oh, sorry. What if it won't let you keep it? You'll get upset again.
You do realize I'm filming a video.
Okay.
I'll upload next episode soon. Bye.